going on, everybody? You are tuned in to the Freshest Crew. My name is Tim on the Furniture.
And this is A2.
This is Sam, a.k.a. Smokestack.
And you go ahead.
Oh, this is all you. This is your introduction, baby.
Oh, yeah, by the way, this is the All Points Podcast.
Yeah,
that's
but
right.
But they already know that.
Or the All Pods Points Cast.
Or the All Pods Podcast.
All Pods Podcast, where we only podcast about other podcasts.
Yeah, don't confuse us with the Point Cast, because we don't like the point. We don't do that shit.
Yeah, we react to other podcasts. We listen to them live and react to them live for you.
Yeah, but we back in here. You all know what we do. Unfortunately, we lost 3 of our soldiers.
May they rest in peace.
May they rest in peace, man.
Them Doja Pickles took them out. The pH balance was off.
But it's just the 3 of us right now. And you know what? I'm going to say this right now. I'm glad it's just the 3 of us. We ain't ever had an episode together.
Right.
You know. So, gentlemen, it's good to see you.
You too.
Now, I don't want to start the episode on a super salty topic.
Uh-oh.
But I'm mad. I'm going to tell you why I'm mad.
Why are you mad?
Because I just wanted some fucking donuts, right?
Oh, shit.
So I'm just cruising down the street. I went over into, and this was the first mistake, but I went over into Casey's because I was like, they probably got a 6 out of 10 donut in there. That's fine, right?
Yeah.
They didn't have none.
Which one you go to?
The one that's like right around the corner on West Street.
Oh, I wouldn't be surprised out here if you got there doing like rush hour time and all. They're gone.
See, but that is, it gets worse.
Oh, shit.
So, wasn't none in there. So, I was like, well, I really want a donut and Dunkin Donuts. They was just right down the street. So, I was like, you know what? I'm just going down there. I'll never go to Dunkin. I'm going to get something, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, the second I get in there, it smells like ass. Oh. Like just not even just like shit, right? Mm-hmm. It is just like open, gaping ass. You know, just like somebody just sitting in the middle
open
of the store.
Booty.
Yeah, and they just don't care. They just like, you know what? You're going to smell my worth.
Oh.
So I go in there and I'm like, okay, this is probably a bad sign, but I want some donuts. Staff is putting up all these fucking like Halloween decorations and getting in the season because it's spooky season and all that. And so I'm like, okay, well, there ain't nobody behind there. I'm going to just use this little kiosk, right? Because, you know, they got in there. I don't want to interrupt them. You know, it just makes more sense, right? So I go in there, and it's got, like, all the list of donuts. And I'm just like, ooh, man, you know what? Jelly donut sounds good. And, you know, I kind of want one of them little chocolate cake, and you know, the chocolate on chocolate with the glaze and shit.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, yeah, I'm going to do that.
Yes,
so,
brother. Preach.
Yep. Just went for both of them. It was, like, $2. I'm like, ooh, and it wasn't even that expensive. This is a good decision. So put in the order, and it says on there, it's like, go down to the next little area to get your donuts and whatnot. So I'm like, I'm a compliant, you know, individual in the society, right? So I go over there, I put my receipt on the counter, and I'm waiting, and this bitch comes up, and she's like, I don't have any of the donuts that you ordered. And I'm like, how? You know, because you know, you expect that when it's like the last few minutes, like, you know, it's like the last 30 minutes working in anywhere where you're making food, right? You expect that at that point.
Yeah, because they throw a ton of them away usually at night.
Yeah,
so they
exactly.
Gotta have some somewhere.
Right, right. No, I go back over there and they've got like the little shelf with all the donuts and whatnot. There's like 8. So I'm just like, okay, why wouldn't you tell me this before I start ordering? Cause like again, wasn't nobody at the counter.
Mm-hmm.
They watched me walk in, so they're like, okay, hey, just so you know, we probably don't have much donuts. You know, you would think customer service would say something like that, right?
Sure,
yeah.
No.
Sure.
So I'm just like, okay, well, I'll just pick something else. And there was one that said like, it was like the because like I said, I wanted a jelly donut, but you know the cream donuts, no homo. No. I wanted one of them instead. So
that ain't cream they're using.
I mean, you know, I ain't trying to get cream in the face by a donut. But so I went ahead and just like, all right, I'm gonna just get one of them. And she didn't say nothing. I was like, I want to get one of them. She's like, oh, that's not up there. And I'm like, the sign says it right there. And she's like, oh, yeah, we just have that in the wrong space. I'm like, how the fuck am I supposed to know that? So I'm like, okay, you know what?
That's crazy.
Nah, this bitch had a, she had a stank ass attitude.
She had a vendetta.
Well, that's why the place smelled like that.
Exactly. Yeah. So I was just like, okay, you know what? Just give me that one right there and give me that one right there. And then she like grabs them, puts it on there. Like there's a little bit of force when she drops that bag on the counter. She's like, have a good day. And I'm just like, you know what? Even in my worst days, I wouldn't be that much of a bitch. So you know what I'm going to do? See, I'm going to be a customer. I'm going back up there because I was like, I got shit to do. But you just right around the corner. So I'm going back after we get done here. I'm getting her goddamn name, and I am about to complain.
Citizen Krigler.
You know what? Because here's the thing. I don't want everybody else to get in trouble, right? Sure. I don't want them to be reprimanded for the shit that she did. But I want her. I got a vendetta against that bitch. So I'm going to just figure out a name in there, and I'm just like. So at 5:20 p.m. on Monday, the 2nd, I was violated. So, yeah. In case you're listening to, I'm coming for you, bitch.
Yeah, you better be ready for all the sprinkles. We're going to take you for all of them.
Yeah, I mean.
She going to come around the corner sprinkles. And start dunking on you.
That's fine.
Dunking her balls on you.
That's nah, terrible, you man. Know, this is what I'm saying. You know, I don't like to call women bitches and whatnot. And you shouldn't. Right. No, you shouldn't. Unless they being a bitch. And she was doing it.
Karen Krigler.
Donut place. Can you call them ditches?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Damn ditches.
So, you know, that was my day. How's your day?
You know, my day ain't been too bad. Tired. But, you know, I'm here. I'm here with the boys. We doing the thing. We doing the show.
That's what we do. We show up. We step up. What about you, Sam?
I ain't got to step up. You got to step up.
Hey, I got my step stool. I'm ready.
That's right.
What about me?
Yeah, what about you?
Yeah, smokestack.
It's been working, man.
Yeah.
It's smell working. Delicious. That's my answer every fucking time.
I know, right? Like, it's just here, every time. Just
every. I got nothing else going on.
This man goes to work.
He smells work delicious right work. Now.
I'm getting a kind of sort of raise, so, like, that's cool.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You was talking about that.
Yeah, so, like, now any of the IT work that I do around the store, I'm gonna get paid $27 an hour for.
Okay.
Versus
what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Yeah, so I'm gonna try and make sure these old ladies have as many issues as they can. So I could just be like, I'm gonna break something intentionally, but do it secretly.
Yeah.
That way they gotta call me back over. I'll be like, I guess I'll do more IT work.
The machine's not counting the coffee beans.
I mean, who knows? Maybe something was just like switched over from being on the blacklist to the whitelist. You know? Or those just flip flopping. Exactly. Nobody can connect. Ugh.
Oh no, damn. Someone unplugged the Wi-Fi router like 3 hours ago. Damn.
We ain't able to do any transactions. We need you up here now, Sam.
What a shame.
But, yeah, man, no, I'm thinking after the holidays, I'm going to be done with this job.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to go back to serving or bartending.
Yeah, you like that one a little bit more,
I,
right?
I do.
Yeah.
A lot. And I've been having a bunch of little plans for how to revitalize the YouTubes.
Oh, yeah.
Not our YouTubes.
Yeah, yeah,
I figured. My own YouTubes.
Which YouTube, you know, is that,
it's,
by the
it's
way?
Dead as fuck. Because I ain't done shit in like over a year.
Oh, damn, it's been that long?
Yeah, it's been probably 2 years now.
Jeez.
It's been a long time.
Even the, because I thought your Twitch stuff went on to your YouTube.
Yeah, but I haven't done Twitch in a long time either.
Ah, okay.
I've stopped everything, man. But, no, I have an idea.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to get 4 videos in the, what's it called? In the chamber, whatever.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to have them ready, make a new channel.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to post those, like, maybe like a week apart.
Right.
Have
right.
a nice thumbnail.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to see.
Okay.
There you go. Get that new channel treatment.
You know what I'm saying?
All right. What you thinking of doing? You got any specific games you trying to stream?
I'm not doing games.
No. All right.
I don't like playing video games on YouTube.
We got to see you playing Mortal Kombat 1.
I'll do that on stream, dog.
Got to play Mortal Kombat 1.
I've been fucking dominating the combat league.
You've been killing them.
Just going up and up and up.
I mean, that's because I ain't got it in yet. All right.
Been making them toasty.
Man, actually, yeah. Right. Yeah, there's a Johnny Cage's second fatality. They, like, threw that in there.
Yeah.
He, like, okay. fucking shadow kicks him into, like, a Lamborghini. Oh. And then opens up the fucking, you know, the wing door, mm-hmm. and their like top half like comes out and like, oh, then he just slams it on their midsection, so it bisects him. And then he hits his little car remote, and the fucking noise that it makes, it goes toasty.
Oh my God.
And then it takes off and blows up.
I'm telling you, no fatalities feel more just impersonal and rude than a Johnny Cage one. Like, they just feel so personal.
His are fucking, he's got two, and they're both just so brutal.
Right, because he's so dumb. He just really doesn't seem like he should be as good as he is. But
bro,
he's the GOAT.
His first fatality he has, he gets the person by the shoulder, and he opens up TikTok on his phone, and it's like a live stream, like selfie, you know. Yeah. And he's like, "Meet Hollywood's newest star." And then he puts the phone down, fucking lifts the person up all the way, and drops into the splits to like bring his face down on a Hollywood Walk of Fame star that has their name on it, and then just like peels it up, and so like their face is gone, and he takes a selfie with them.
Wow.
And
it's
like, that's that fucking, is what he would do, man. Like,
it's just so fucking like the splits, bro.
Imagine being so disrespectful. A regular pedestrian in the Mortal Kombat world, and he's literally streaming shit like that. It's like, bro, what is wrong with him?
I mean, but that's like on brand. So on brand for like fucking Johnny Cage, though.
I feel like he'd be like our Kanye West or something. They're like, oh God, Johnny Cage at it again. Aww. Just killing people on the live. Man. Why is he never arrested?
That's I don't think that's too far from Kanye. He sounded like he might have done some shit like that.
It's only a matter of time till Kanye is like live streaming execution somewhere. Like,
nah,
some
man.
Dignitary invites him somewhere. He's like, that man stole from him, and now his hands will be cut off by dogs.
You ain't heard of My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy 2?
Is that an already existing album, or is this another one?
That's not what it's going to be called, but you know how that one was his like comeback album after the VMAs? Mm. This is his comeback album after becoming Hitler. Or sorry, after becoming Yadolf.
Is this the one that he made in the house with no electricity and walls?
He's been working on it, but Ty Dolla $ign just posted a Instagram story clip of a brand new verse in a club in Europe.
And I guarantee you, I ain't gonna listen to none of that shit.
Me either.
I mean, okay.
I almost want to, just because last time he was so, what's the word?
Manic.
Like, shunned from society. And manic.
Yeah.
He put out some fucking heat.
I mean, I guess. Well, which one are you talking about? You talking
My
about
Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy.
Okay, yeah. I mean, like, in that point right there, because that was, like, right after 808s and Heartbreaks, right? If I remember the chronology, whatever.
No, that was after Graduation.
Really?
Yeah. No. It was after 808s.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. My bad.
Yeah. So like, I think you get a. It's like a Windows release. You get a bad Kanye album, then you get a good one, then a bad one, then a good one.
It's like a Windows release.
So I don't think.
I see what he did there. I just caught it.
But you get, what is it? What was the last one? Was it like Donda? Donda 2.
Donda, yeah.
Well, Donda 2 never officially released.
Was he just had the little.
It was only on Stim player.
That one that had Hurricane on it with The Weeknd.
That was Donda.
That was the first
Donda 1.
See, and that was a terrible album. So,
I'm going to just start saying from now on, people are like, have you listened to the new Kanye album? I'm like, nah, I'm an atheist. Like, what you mean? Like, well, he's God, right?
And I'm like, that's funny.
That's going to be my new Kanye joke.
I mean, okay, if he does, I'll probably listen to it. I'll probably listen just so then I can maximize the amount of hate I can get.
It's like watching a car wreck. Yeah.
But he
like
has,
you wish it wouldn't happen.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's there. You might as well take a look.
I mean, he has to address the whole, like, you know, Hitler shit.
I tell you what, if he calls the album Yadolf, I will buy a physical copy.
Yeah.
You got to own that vinyl to own it.
I will buy the vinyl.
He better be in some like SS shit. You know what I mean? Like
a Yeezy version of the Adolf costume.
Yeah, exactly.
It's just going to be that picture that paparazzi took of him in that German police shirt with him just wearing socks.
Wait, what?
You know what I'm talking about?
It's going to be him painting.
He had like shaved eyebrows and a shirt that said Polizzi or some shit.
It's going to be a picture of him painting, but he's going to be sitting down and his pants will be down getting top from his wife. Did I see something the other day saying that the Adidas CEO said that what Kanye said wasn't anti-Semitic, kind of like they're backing off what they did before? I'm like, oh, well, welcome him back with open arms or something.
You know, probably.
They still have all that Yeezy back stock they got to get rid of.
So. I'm surprised they haven't already.
They still selling it at this point. So it's just they like, what's the point of dropping them? You're still selling all the stuff.
Yeah. You know what's crazy? Is they was planning on just burning it. And yeah. I'm like, what a corporation thing to do.
Yeah.
Like, you could give those away.
Right.
I mean, that would only make him more Hitler, though. At that point.
Shit.
They're just playing into it.
God damn.
We need to take a commercial break.
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah. I mean, like, that's crazy. I was expecting them to, like, be just rid of those. Because, like, it's the pre-Hitler Kanye fucking Yeezys, right? I would imagine stuff like that would probably sell.
Yeah.
Or at least you just like be a collector and whatnot.
You'd think.
Just hold on to them.
I don't know. Y'all keep talking. I'm going to check.
I don't know. I don't think I'd want to own a pre-Third Reich Hitler painting still.
Okay, so if you could, if like you knew it was like a Hitler portrait, like one that he painted, right?
Mm-hmm.
And some like, you know, some nice old lady was like, yeah, my husband, he was a collector. And I never knew what this painting was, but I just kind of want to get rid of it because it just reminds me of him. You want to cop that shit?
Oh, absolutely. I'm going to sell it to some neo-Nazi.
Okay, I do not condone Hitler and anything that he's done, but I will make money off the motherfucker.
Exactly. Like, I mean, this is probably isn't one I wouldn't have done. But I mean, hell, people are out here buying like the gloves that OJ supposedly killed his wife with, the gun that killed
Trayvon
and shit. And I'm like, there's all kinds of weird people out there that want that stuff that will pay top dollar for it. Like, if it's going to go into circulation, it might as well go into my pockets.
I mean,
that Trayvon one is so fucked up.
Yeah. Bro. And so Zimmerman himself sold it. I'm like, I feel like legally he should not have been allowed to do that.
With that dude, he like leaned into, oh, I'm a killer or some shit like that. You know, he was like, wasn't he like signing fucking Skittles bags and shit?
Probably.
Yeah.
So like,
I wouldn't be surprised.
Just a disgusting piece of shit.
Yeah.
Also, Yeezys are probably cheaper than they've ever been.
Oh, really?
Even
really?
Resales are like 170.
Wait, how much are they usually though?
I mean, they used to go for like 300.
Yeah. See, but I still don't get it. Them's my personal opinion. There's some ugly ass shoes.
Yeah, thank you. They are. Yeah. I have not seen one pair of Yeezys that looks good.
Mm-hmm.
Don't Kyle own a pair of Yeezys?
Yes, probably. He does. And I still say that they ugly. It's the design, man. Like they just look. They look like they belong in like a sci-fi movie of like the 80s. And I'm just like, you know, not in like sci-fi nerd cool way, like wearing a Battlestar Galactica shirt or something. It's like, nah, like that belongs on the set.
Do y'all know the little trivia behind Crocs in what's it called? Oh my God, why can't I? Idiocracy.
No. Yes.
Yeah. So in Idiocracy, the director was just like, I had to find like a pair of shoes that just looked so ridiculous that nobody would wear.
Mm-hmm.
They were Crocs.
Okay.
So I feel like that's what's gonna happen. You know, but in kind of in like a reverse.
Mm.
You know, we have like some shoes that a lot of people are buying.
Mm-hmm.
Then later on, it'd be like, yeah. Well. Aside from Kyle, because, you know, Kyle is he's a genius.
Kyle, you got some ugly ass shoes.
He said it, not me, but I agree.
But no, I hate Crocs too, honestly. I'm like, I don't know, something about wearing like flip flops. Just wear the flip flops. I'm like, holy shoes feels like a bad idea because I'm like, your feet are just going to get wet.
I mean,
supposedly they're super comfy.
Yeah,
I'm sure they
true
are,
that is.
Wasn't like escalators chewing up Crocs some years ago at one point in time? People were getting their feet stuck.
It wouldn't surprise me. I mean, like those. I mean, I guess I don't really know how I wouldn't do that with like a regular shoe or not. You know,
right.
I mean, they're basically just rubber, like entire rubber. So I don't know. I'll never wear any Crocs seriously. But if I were to, them shits is going to be 100% in sports mode. Every time.
If I do, I'm going full on design them because, you know, they got those pins now you can like buy and design your Crocs with. Like, I guess I'm just used to when I first saw them really being around, you always saw like the really, really obese people that like where the ankle and the knee or the ankle and the calf are like the same thickness. and they don't even pick their feet up when they walk. You always saw them wearing Crocs. Yep.
Yeah.
And I'm like, they don't seem like regular people shoes to me, but everyone wears them now. And I'm like, I guess.
I would say that the only benefit to them probably is because you got a lot of ventilation and whatnot. Mm-hmm. So, you know, your feet don't get too hot, which means they don't stink as much.
See, I thought about wearing some of them on a float trip before because I'm like, you know, if you put them in sport mode, then they shouldn't come off because, you know, you've been down to know. You know how it goes sometimes. If you don't bring the right pair of water shoes, them rocks are fucking your feet up. Man. That first year, my feet felt awful.
I tried to. So I bought the ones like at the ranch and whatnot. Mm-hmm. The ones that you can like barely make tight enough to stay on and then just loosen every. Yeah. Nah, that was the worst decision of my life.
I usually just bought them from Walmart because I'm like, they're going to tear up anyways. And I won't be able to use them next year.
Right.
Like, I had lacerations in the bottom of them from the rocks. I was like, God damn. I was like, I should get some Crocs for this. But then I was like, what if the rocks get in my Crocs?
Yeah. And then you just, I mean, I guess it ain't nothing. You just got to flip that off.
True.
Dump them and then you good.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
I don't know, man. I'm not big on like buying shoes. I got the same pair of shoes I've had for like 2 years. I don't need to change.
I like shoes, but like I'm also like I got my pairs I wear all the time and some that I wear occasionally. They're my like going out shoes, but that's about it. I don't buy them very often. I buy shoes like maybe once a year.
Yeah, same.
Comes down to it. Same. So you said something earlier that maybe Rose, you were talking about getting into the season. She was talking about, you know, them getting the store ready for Halloween, right?
Yeah.
Nah, wrong season, my brother, because do you know who's already thawed out?
she ain't thawed out yet. No, she's
literally
she's,
2 days from now, she's starting her Christmas tickets go on sale for her Christmas tour. Mariah's like, here we go.
You know, but I'm gonna be real. Like, I don't know if y'all remember last year when she posted on, I think it was like on Twitter, and she had that little clip where she was like, you know, she was like a witch at the end of October, and she went, and then it just slowly went to like the Christmas Mariah.
Yeah,
nah, that shit was good.
She plays into it well, like the whole that she's basically a meme for it at this point. And I'm like, oh, she cannot wait.
I mean, it's that's when she gets paid.
That's true.
You know how many people are playing that goddamn song?
Too fucking many.
Yeah,
I found this TikTok account.
Yeah,
that does like a live chart of like week by week, like the number one song of like each year or whatever, and so on. Every fucking year,
wait,
like for a couple weeks on the little thing, or like just 1 week on the thing, you'll just hear the
yeah.
Oh god.
Yeah.
Wait. So every year since when?
I don't know. I went as far back as
since she first thawed out.
But it wouldn't surprise me if like every year since
yeah when it came out,
because it was huge when it came out. But hey, you know what?
Still hits number one every year.
It don't surprise me.
I gotta give it to her. She's not tired of singing it yet, obviously, because she's doing it. Most people like.
I mean, she can't sing it anymore.
Yeah, so, that's true. Yeah,
cigarettes. But what was it like Tyler the Creator? He was a Yonkers. He doesn't like performing Yonkers anymore. But that was like one of his big songs.
Yeah, that was like the first thing that really blew up with him.
He don't like doing it anymore because he's done it for so long. Now he's like, I don't want to sing that. Oh, sorry, let me do the Tyler voice. I don't want to sing that fucking song no more.
Well, you know, it's also because it was just a song he made intentionally to make himself blow up.
Okay, right? Yeah. And then plus, if he got something like, because like Earthquake, that is my number one song with Tyler.
Yeah.
So you know, he got better shit to perform. So.
Can I make a hot take about Tyler the Creator?
Who's that?
Tyler the Creator is the more classy Lil Nas X. Like, he's on the like LGBTQ plus spectrum there,
yeah,
but he's not an antagonistic person like how Lil Nas X is.
How the fuck is he antagonistic?
I will say that Lil Nas X thrives off of conflict because now, granted, those people keep coming to him.
Yeah.
And starting shit with him. Mm-hmm. And that's what keeps him relevant. Like, you guys are the ones that keep him relevant. You don't like that he's relevant, but you're keeping him relevant by the fact that you keep talking to him. But he just eats that shit up, and he'll be like,
so it's not his fault.
He's not the antagonist. He's just the.
He revels in the chaos. He's the chaotic neutral, I guess you could say. He's like, oh, he's like, they hate that I'm gay. Wait till they see me release these pregnancy pictures. I'm like, God damn it. He just keeps upping the ante. But like Tyler just be like, yeah, I like coochie, but I suck dick too. Shut the fuck up. And I'm like, he's just funny, man.
Man. Okay, so I was just thinking, like, why haven't they done a collab? But why haven't Nas X and fucking Doja Cat done a collab?
Because Doja's a piece of shit.
I mean, she is, without a doubt, but...
And Lil Nas knows it.
Yeah, okay, that's probably it.
Yeah, you know what? If he did a collab with her, it would probably somehow end up sinking his career, because, like, while they're doing it, she would probably be doing something either extremely insensitive or racist, and then he'd be caught up in it.
Let me tell you.
Yeah.
I think this would be the fucking blow the top off collab of 2023.
What's that?
Oh, yeah?
Lil Nas X and Eminem. Could you imagine?
Only if Eminem is allowed to drop as many F-bombs as he can.
Oh, that would be fun. Like, they're rap battling each other the whole time. Like, they're making songs together, but it's really them, like, battling each other constantly.
I would watch that shit.
That would be, like, the Elton John collab times 10.
But see, that's the thing. It's like the whole idea of like fucking Eminem being homophobic is kind of like,
yeah, it's simmered a lot, you know? since that song Fall he did.
I've heard some stuff that people are like, he's not actually homophobic there. Like, he's actually more for gay people than people realize he is, but because of what he was saying.
Yeah.
He always has been. It's just his, when your whole fucking brand is built off of shock content, it's kind of hard to get away from that.
Because that's what Hobson, for a while, like, he had a little bit of that shock content, but now that he was doing more serious shit, nobody really pays attention to him.
He's also corny as fuck.
I mean, a little bit.
Hobson.
But I like a lot of what Hobson does, but the shit that he, like, Illmind Hobson, that shit's dope.
No, that shit is dope.
Those are, they fucking go hard.
Shit is dope.
But
Hobson kind of shit the bed when he... What was that line he said? He really thought he was clever with it. He was like, talk about how like his teachers were always on his ass because he wasn't paying attention or whatever. But he wanted to be successful in a different way.
Huh.
And then he was like, did the man who invented college go to college? Okay then.
That's... Is he wrong though?
Yes!
Come on, man. This is I'm 14 and this is deep type shit. Yeah. Like,
but at the same time, they probably didn't have an argument for him when he said that. Like, it was like,
it wasn't invented yet, dog. I mean, like,
it's like the whole what was it in the Biggie movie when the teacher was like, you know, you're not gonna amount to anything. You're just gonna be a trash man. And he's just like, trash man gets paid more than the teacher does, and then just shut her up. He's like, well, all right.
You know, sometimes I think about what I would do if I was a trash man. And I would take a quick commercial break.
Fuck.
We'll be right back.
Steve Jobs killed Tupac.
It's canon.
It's a canon event.
So we were in the commercial
I'm sorry. I'm just picturing Steve Jobs in his little turtleneck and jeans.
Just in like a dark alleyway with like a fucking Glock or something.
He's like, look me in my eyes, Pac. And then he looks away because he can't look at people in the eyes.
He called it the eye shot, Tupac. That's his little memoir.
There's like a iPhone that's like locked away in Apple's like headquarters and whatnot. It's like, don't open until 2025, or and then, you know, they just it releases and whatnot, and it's got all his hits and whatnot.
Yes.
He's the one that was taking out those Clinton oppositions. You know what I
mean? He's the one that got Jeffrey Epstein locked up.
Steve Jobs killed Jeffrey Epstein. Yes.
Yeah, but speaking of killers, y'all hear about Pac or the dude who supposedly
Yeah, Steve Jobs.
Shut the fuck up.
No, yeah. The dude who has been under suspicion for like the last few
20 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he admitted to it like years ago when they're just now even doing anything about it?
Yeah.
Well, I guess he didn't admit to it per se, but.
You know what's wild?
What's that?
This case has been going on for longer than Tupac was alive.
Yeah. Like, that is just insane to me.
Didn't even know that was a possibility.
27 years.
In this case.
It's just like, I get the reasons why, because I mean, he's such a high profile person. Well, I mean, mm-hmm. even to this day, you got people who are like in high school saying, "Oh yeah, Punk is the greatest," you know. So I mean, like, the name is still out there, and whatnot.
Yeah,
and people want some resolution, but like, I mean, like, yeah, you're talking about the dude who was in the case who basically admitted to it. He did that shit. What was it, like 2011 or some shit like
yeah,
that?
It was a long time ago.
Yeah. And they just now I get it though, because it was like they gotta get the evidence and shit together.
Yeah.
But like, man, that's fucking wild though.
It is.
Yeah, I mean, I heard you guys talking about it there, you know, with the last episode, everything that was going on with it, like the fact that his music's about to his music's about to go public or something. Someone else is about to own his masters. I can't remember exactly what it is you guys said, but basically there's something going on with like his music now to where it's like they can start releasing the stuff, and it's just like, convenient that we lock somebody up just in time for that.
Hey, even more convenient is the fact that Diddy starting to release people, or right, give them back.
Yeah, right.
I heard that.
You know? I bet you he's putting in the contract, like, yeah, you can have this back, but you have to testify for me.
Yeah,
right? I believe it.
I mean, the Diddy question.
He's that dude where it's just like, you know, I'm sure he probably didn't do anything illegal to take these people's music. Like, it was probably in a contract, and they just didn't understand it.
Mm-hmm.
But did he probably do something in a moral way to get it to happen? Like, make the contract look all fucky so they didn't know what they were doing.
Yeah, I mean, some of just course. Like corporate bullshit.
It's just like, you know, I'm surprised anyone does business with him still now. Honestly, I'm like, it's literally known he will fuck you over.
Yeah, I mean, like, Bad Boy as a company, I'm sure that like after Big died, there was like just a handful of people who even wanted to work with him.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then it was just a matter of like, I mean, he's got a name so I can get out there. And then,
right.
Yeah, but. Yeah.
Which is crazy. You would have never thought a company by the name of Bad Boy would ever be a prevalent. Like, that's like nowadays you see some of these LLCs people come up with there. They'd be like blackskinscrub.com. And it's just like, yeah, that one's not going to take. But yeah.
Or like Schwindel Management or something like that.
Yeah, you know, like. Schwindel Management.
Oh man.
But yeah.
So Diddy might be going to court.
Yeah, I mean, good. Because if he's like, I don't know if you know about the dude who, I think his name is like Keith or something like that. We'll just call him Keith.
Sure.
Yeah. But he was basically like, yeah, Diddy told us that he'd give us $1 million for both of their heads.
Yeah. So apparently from, because I did a lot of research on this a while back, and the prevailing story is that it was kind of an open-ended thing.
Uh-huh.
Like, he didn't specifically hire anybody.
Yeah.
It was just like, man, I'm tired of this motherfucker. I'll, you know, pay $1 million to see his ass dead or some shit.
And yeah.
It was just, like, put into the ether.
Yeah.
In such a way that it's like, oh, well.
It was stochastic.
You know?
Yeah. So. Like, you know, man, it would sure be great if somebody popped Jonathan the Great's tire, but, you know, I mean, like, nobody would do that, right? You
know? Like, projecting out there, I sure wish somebody would kill Pac for $1 million.
Yeah.
Boy, they would make my day.
Oh, man, and if they took out Suge at the same time, woo, man, that would just make Bad Boy stock go up.
Right. Yeah. Like, we need to stop Suge specifically because, you know, he out here injecting people with AIDS, man. He a whole supervillain.
We talking about Suge Knight or Suge White?
Suge Knight, sir.
Okay, you gotta.
Suge White don't inject nobody with nothing. All I inject are turkeys.
But nah, man.
You got a kid?
Huh?
You got a kid?
I got three.
So you injected somebody with something.
Fair enough.
Multiple times.
All right, he got me.
Must be very comfortable for Kyle to hear.
I know, I can't hear. Hey, Kyle, guess what? Nah, I'm not. Nah, I ain't gonna go there.
Could you imagine?
Oh, man. But, yeah, I didn't know anything about all of this until dude got arrested, and I started looking into it, and I'm like, oh, my God. Like, the context around Killshot, when he's like, he put out a hit is the day Diddy admits that he put the hit out that got Pac killed.
Ah.
That puts that into perspective, and I'm like, oh, this is actually some truth to it.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know if it's actually true, but we'll find out in court.
We'll find out in court.
But if he does go, what are the chances that y'all think he'll actually be convicted?
He'll get off.
Yeah.
He'll get off.
Yeah. And then he'll be convicted.
Somebody will have to take that fall for him. They'll get Diddy arrested before they get, or sorry, they'll get Diddy locked up before Trump gets locked up.
Man. Probably.
What if he's like, no, that wasn't me. That was Puff.
Oh, yeah, right.
That was a whole separate identity. I plead insanity.
Damn.
Too bad he's not on speaking terms with Master P no more. He might be able to get some rap snacks from the commissary for free.
Yo, could you imagine a whole new defense? The Puffy defense?
See, that was
what the hell?
When I had a different moniker. Oh, damn. Camera died.
Camera cut off.
Ain't that a bitch?
Damn, Kyle, record your shit and quit recording sex tapes.
I mean, nah.
Nah, he too vanilla for that.
Nah. Oh, wait, you think he's too vanilla?
I think he too vanilla
nah,
for that.
Nah, man, Kyle a freak.
Nah.
He Kyle, ain't no freak.
Kyle, nah. Kyle's putting on that, we gonna get tipsy. You know,
man,
that
speaking of Kyle, I got to see Chiron the other night.
Oh, really?
That was not Kyle.
Wait, where at?
That was Kyle.
Oh, at Revolution?
Man, I fucking tried getting into Revolution.
Yeah.
And because like, okay, so I was out because I had to go pick up a drill.
Yeah, okay.
Because
yeah.
A drill was fucked up. And they was like, a drill can't drive. You need to pick him up. I was like, all right, cool. I got him. So I get there and I'm trying to get inside Rev. And apparently, at whatever time it was, like sometime past 11,
yeah,
they just retroactively decided to instill a dress code.
Mm.
So I get there. And he's like, oh, you can't come in. I was like, why? He's like, you're wearing shorts. It's like, you can't wear shorts. I was like, the fuck? And like, I saw other people.
Yeah, I saw that.
Inside shorts. Wearing shorts. And I'm just like, the fuck? And so I lied to the dude. I was like, well, I already paid my cover. He was like, you did? I was like, yeah, man, I already paid my cover, dog. And so like, you know. Either give me that bag or let me in. He was like, oh, all right. So like he just gave me the $5. I was like, cool. And then I took the $5. And then I saw a homeless dude, bless you. And the homeless dude was like, hey man, you got any money? I was like, yeah, man, I just took $5 from the club. Here you go. I just gave it to him.
Wait, where'd you see him at? Because I ran into some dude that night.
Right
too.
By the steps of Revolution.
Okay, I didn't say dude then.
But anyway, then like we all met up at XY instead.
Yeah.
And then I see Chiron and he's dancing, he's smiling. I was like, Kyle, smiling?
Smiling?
It's like, what the fuck?
I don't know.
This man's smiling? And then there's a drill, he's drunk. And fucking, what's it called? Back to Back came on. This is an opinion Kyle gave.
Hmm.
He said it goes, ether. Fuck, what's that? The Tupac diss against Biggie. I fucked your bitch mother. Yeah, hit him up. He said it goes ether, hit him up, and Back to Back. That's Kyle's top three that's Chiron's top three diss tracks.
If you don't, okay, I'm gonna be a fucking old head.
So now I wanna talk about that now.
Well, I'm gonna be an old head on top of a little rap elitist.
Mm-hmm.
But if you don't know Acknowledged by Master Ace, and you don't put that on your list, you ain't in the conversation.
You think it's top three?
Oh, yeah. 100%. Okay.
Gentlemen, surely you are not forgetting Rap Devil by Machine Gun Kelly. He smoked Eminem. Oh, what Jesus. Do you mean?
He turned Eminem into Skittles.
He said, your name's Sixlet now.
Oh, hell. Not Sixlet.
Bro, Sixlets are so fucking nasty, man. Like, my God. I don't know how that candy is still in circulation anywhere.
See, that's how I should have known something was wrong. Because Sixlets were my ex's favorite candy.
That red flag right there. Bro, that shell is weird.
We're
man.
Adding that to the red flag like list.
Exactly, yeah.
If your favorite flag or favorite candy is Sixlets, it's a red flag.
I mean, so what are the beefs, though? Because, you know, I mean, like, ether, I think I agree with that one. I think that's probably, like, top tier, right?
Yeah. No Vaseline, though?
Nah.
You ain't gonna put no Vaseline in there?
Nah.
Ice Cube cooked the whole gang. Nah. Like, you saw it straight out of Compton. Like, what was it? MC Ren and the other ones, they was like, damn, what the fuck did I do?
It was like that fucking that 50 Cent shit. Why he call me a bitch?
He like, damn, I thought we was good to go. Like, he don't even, when he was part of the crew, he didn't even acknowledge me, and now he talking shit on me.
Man.
What about shit, I was about to be like extra old. Boogie Down Productions.
I ain't heard that one.
Damn.
Yeah, I was about to go extra.
Damn.
No, I mean, like, that's just something that don't really, it ain't out there no more. Like, people don't do like diss records no more.
Not good ones at the time, at least. I mean, mainly it's because the beefs they're not on the same level. Like, when you got Meek Mill against Drake, obviously, you gonna expect Drake to body him there. Like, it's not even a question. Like, back when it was like things like, you know, Easy, Cube, Pac, Biggie, you got people on the same level. They don't be on the Machine Gun killing Eminem. Again, not on the same level. Like, he flamed him so bad he switched genres. Like, come on, man. Like, it was not the same level. Like, that's why they don't work like that now. Everybody would be wanting to have beef. It'd be like,
I think another part of it too, man, is like, there's not many like big music people who are just rapping to rap anymore. Yeah, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's about hits and shit.
Yeah. I will say this though.
And I should say a bunch of sneak disses too.
Yeah, yeah, right.
You know what I mean?
Well, see, the fact that you say that, did y'all hear that leak from Kendrick?
Yeah.
Yeah, when he was talking about, so like, was it Element, wasn't it? I think it was Element.
Yeah, it was Element.
Who was he going at?
It was Element.
So the real version of Element leaked. And Kendrick was dissing.
He poo-pooed on Big Sean so hard, man. He poo-pooed on him so bad.
I forget the line, but he said something to the like, you know, it's just not my job to make you famous. Or he's like, his old album, what was it? Now I'm Famous or whatever the fuck that album is. And he's like, you're only famous not for your raps, but for who you dating? Because he's with...
Ariana Grande.
Yeah, he's with her.
And then Janae Aiko.
Yeah. So I was like, damn. And I mean, it shows, because where is he now?
True. I haven't heard anything from him in years since what was that song? When you said it was over,
you ain't heard him since Beware.
I ain't heard him since Beware, dog. At least nothing that mattered.
That's like 2014.
Exactly.
Man. I mean, he released that one album with what's that fucking track? Moves on it. That song was a hit.
I don't keep up with a whole lot of current music anymore. Too many littles. Yeah,
this is what Kendrick said. All right, I'm not gonna rap it. I'm just gonna read it. He said,
"But you ain't down. You ain't going."
I would not want that Kendrick smoke.
He said, "Big Sean keeps sneak dissing. I let it slide. I think his false confidence got him inspired. I can't make him respect you, baby. It's not my job. You're finally famous for who you date, not how you rhyme.
Yeah,
cute ass raps get your puberty up, then make you a classic album before you come at us. Drake and Meek Mill beef might got you gassed up, but I'm a whole nother beast. I really fuck you up.
Yeah.
He's like." And he said, get your puberty up. Like, that's fucking crazy.
Like, for real. Like, I don't think, because they was always talking about it for years, of like Drake versus Kendrick. Mm-hmm. I think if Drake would have, if his ego would have just been a little bit bigger and he tried that shit, nah.
See, here's where it goes with it. Drake, for the most part, is bodying most people in disses, but Drake don't really challenge people on his level.
Exactly.
So, like, if he went after, like you said, Kendrick, if he went after Gambino, if he went after I can't even really think of a whole lot more of them. It was like, you got people out here who actually are, you know, like free thinkers and have their own mind and style, and they will crush your ass because they're just more creative than Drake. Drake does a lot of subliminal
a
shit
lot
with his, like
of
that
subliminal.
Whole, oh, he killed X, maybe I should do a 20, maybe I should do a 10. Like, it's like, okay, it was a little bit of clever wordplay, but like, you doing too much for it, dog. Like,
yeah,
that was just one diss and it took you that long to say it.
I just like, whenever he's like very vocal about,
and he's dead,
he's talking about, yeah, like whenever he's very vocal about who he's dissing, he goes after people like Macklemore, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, that was like the weakest shit I ever saw. Yeah,
I'm sorry, you got to be feeling pretty low on yourself to be trying to diss with Macklemore. I'm like, why?
It's like just the happiest dude in fucking hip hop.
Leave him alone. He thrift shopping. Like, I mean, let the man be.
Yeah.
Go after Jack Harlow.
I just honestly, I don't really get the appeal of Drake. I heard something that he was like, one hit away from being bigger than Michael Jackson as far as like number one. Which,
but he'll never be Michael Jackson.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's that. There is a good argument to make on that, because like there's a lot of influence that Drake has over just pop culture and whatnot, and the things that he's introduced. So I mean, like,
you can push it more in different ways than you could back when Michael Jackson was at his peak too. Yeah. So
that's true.
Speaking of, I don't know if it was aimed at Drake or not, but you hear that new Yachty J. Cole joint?
Nah.
I think I saw something about it, though. I hadn't listened to it.
Yachty gets in his, like, three stacks bag.
Hmm.
Like, it feels like an Andre flow.
Really?
And then, you know, J. Cole does basically the same flow. But it gets to this one point. He doesn't say any names specifically, but he's like, I can see a lot of influence in the way you dress and something you're trying to impress. And he's basically just talking about somebody who all they do is just they try to stay around young people to try and catch the next wave and just use that for relevancy versus making actual substance.
I mean, that's all he's done.
Yeah.
You know, just wrote whatever wave was coming up.
That's another one. Drake could not. I don't think he could body J. Cole either.
Oh, no. No.
That's smoke you don't want.
That's something I want to see, though.
I would want to see it.
Like, I'm not saying them two specifically. I want to see Cole, like actually diss somebody.
Yeah.
Like, really go in.
To be honest with you, I don't.
I don't think he would.
Yeah.
Because, like, you know what I mean? He's just.
Why?
Why don't I want to see? Because I don't think, like, at this point.
No, I mean, I think he'd be like, why would I? Like,
yeah, exactly.
Exactly. Yeah. But it's just like, I want to know.
You want to know how he...
What's under the hood there?
But what if that was the whole reason? Is that he didn't want to because he, like, ain't really got the chops for it? You know? I mean, like, it's the whole idea of, like, who is it that cannabis. Like, cannabis was, like, a just impossible-to-beat battle rapper, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like, people feared cannabis. But the second that he goes into actually making music, shit was doo-doo.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, maybe that's...
I can see that.
Shit don't always translate, man.
It does not.
Don't always translate.
You know, it's funny, talking about J. Cole, I saw something interesting the other day. So, you know, Aaron Rodgers for the Jets got injured and everything. They're out for the season. And Colin Kaepernick sent them a letter wanting to be their practice squad QB. It was like a 2-page letter saying why he would be a good practice squad QB for them.
Mm-hmm.
And like, but it wasn't Colin Kaepernick who released this letter. It was J. Cole. I'm like, why the fuck does J. Cole have this letter? I'm like, it didn't make a lick of sense.
J. Cole got access to Cap's Gmail or something.
Apparently, I'm like, dog, is this your agent or something? Like, let me know. Or you know what?
Colin Kaepernick managed by J. Cole. Yeah.
They're the same person. Have you ever seen Colin Kaepernick and J. Cole in the same place?
Oh, man. Come to think of it, if I Google it right now, I might come up with some AI, so it's never happened. So you might be right.
Conveniently hasn't been able to play in the league for years.
So, and J. Cole released this album called The Off Season.
Oh.
See?
Oh.
Oh.
The J. Cap question.
You got a whole new conspiracy.
We know who you are now, sir.
So, just while we're on this topic, because I know you're I wouldn't say huge, but, you know, you're a Cole fan.
Yeah, yeah.
You're a fan of Cole.
Yeah, yeah.
I've been seeing a lot of discourse lately that, I mean, obviously everyone on the internet always hates on Cole, but.
Jermaine. Cole.
Yeah, that one.
Jermaine.
Jesus.
So anyway, basically what they get at is he's got great features, but all of his songs are doo-doo because he's the one producing a lot of them. And people are saying he's not a good producer.
I mean,
I might call Cap.
Huh? Yeah, yeah, you might have to.
Oh, here it goes.
Hello? Yeah, again. Something to be done about the internet. Them tweets ain't tweeting, right?
I mean, that right there is just, if you want to say that you don't like his production, that's fine.
That's fine.
But he's executive produced basically all of his albums.
Man.
So,
in my opinion, there's not a single bad beat on The Off Season.
I don't think so either.
I think every single one of those beats is.
I just think it's you're getting people who are in that, like, like the people who were bumping like Soulja Boy and whatnot, trying to like judge somebody like Cole, you know, like the real Cat in the Hat kind of rhymes, people who like that shit.
You got a lot of people out there who just literally judge an artist based off of the features that they get, and it's like, oh, well, he's got too many songs without features, that's not good. It's like, you can have an album without a shit ton of features and it'd be all right. Like, if there was an artist I would say who does better in features than he does in his own music, it would probably be Lil Baby. Like, I think Lil Baby bodies when he's a feature, but I've tried to listen to his own music and it just didn't draw me in quite the same way.
I ain't never listened to it, so you know, you
see, he like the only little out here that I ever kind of gave any attention to there, but I like his flow.
Okay,
so
you know, Cole produced High Power on Section 80. Really? Yeah,
can he just make the album with Kendrick already? Because I will buy that vinyl, like, in regard. Yes,
they can't handle two niggas too clever.
Bro, no speaker can. They'll all blow up. Speaking of clever rapping niggas, though, you know who I just found out the other day is disabled, actually?
Oh.
Andre 3000.
Wait, really?
Yeah, you know, the dude has, he has anxiety and, what's the other one? Hypersensitivity disorder, and they pair together. So, basically, he becomes, like, hyper fearful and anxious in large crowds, which is crazy considering that
he does it.
But that's why he said he doesn't really do his own albums like that, because it gets to him to where he can't do it. Like, it with his medication, he's able to get things done there, but dude has like extreme stage fright even still to this day.
That's crazy. Like, was this like something in the Outkast heyday that was like, was that present back then?
I don't think he knew about it back then. Like, okay, that's so what was going on. It was probably just like I feel this pounding, you know, we're going on the show. But the thing is, he got diagnosed later, probably after he got with Badu, truthfully. But you know,
see,
but yeah,
that'll tell you how much like you got to be passionate about that shit to make a career out of that, even though like you'd be scared as fuck on stage.
Yeah,
because like, I mean, like I said, I've definitely felt some of that, but it was like pre any performance, like, right before getting on. I'm a little like What's going on, everybody? This is A2, chief editor of the All Points Podcast. Unfortunately, we had some technical difficulties, so this episode is cut short. But anyways, see us later.